There's a lot of misinformation, misinterpretations, and outright lies being spread about Italy's Campi Flegrei Volcano. Therefore, this video is largely dedicated to discussing the actual cause of the volcano's ongoing unrest. But first, I need to debunk something. What seemed to wrongfully set off the latest wave of social media spread nonsense was a scientific paper that found a specific fault line within Campi Flegrei was potentially capable of producing a magnitude 5 range earthquake. However, this really isn't new information. Campi Flegrei has been known to contain multiple faults which could theoretically produce a magnitude 5 range earthquake for multiple years, and here's the thing. This isn't particularly special. All you need for a magnitude 5.0 earthquake to occur is an active fault line at least 1,700 meters long. Fault lines of this length exist within almost every nation, state, and territory that exists. In Italy, such active faults exist all over the place, and few faults ever end up producing their maximum theoretical quakes, especially not on a frequent basis. While yes, some of the area within Campi Flegrei's calderas have proven to be especially susceptible to earthquake damage from moderate magnitude quakes, just like the island of Ischia, we cannot predict earthquakes regardless of where they occur with current science. So, what is actually causing Campi Flegrei's current unrest, and how does it compare to other recent episodes of unrest at the volcano? Well, Campi Flegrei's ongoing unrest, which began in 2005, was triggered by the slow migration of both magma and magmatic fluids to shallower depths. The magma intrusion component specifically is ascending from a deeper magma reservoir at 8 kilometers depth into a far smaller but expanding sill or laccolith-like body at around 3.5 kilometers depth. While the amount of magma that has ascended since 2005 is widely debated, my best guess suggests around 90 million cubic meters of molten rock. This total, if uplift continues at a rate of 18 centimeters or 7.1 inches a year, likely indicates the addition of around 10 or 11 million cubic meters a year. As shown in this diagram, this uplifts and domes overlying rock, creating the ground deformation above it and leading to volcanic earthquakes which accommodate the strain placed on local faults from said uplift. While this total of magma is 3 times the amount of molten rock that the 1980s seismic crisis and evacuations were linked to, and is at slightly shallower depths, there is one key difference. There seems to be substantially less hydrothermal fluids and rising gas from the 2005 to present magma intrusion than the 1982 to 1985 one, hence the lower uplift rate. Hydrothermal fluids and gas can cause uplift on their own after all. While the ongoing intrusion is notably larger than other episodes of unrest, it is still for all intents and purposes fairly small. In a worst-case scenario, if all the magma were to somehow miraculously all explosively erupt tomorrow with absolutely no effusive component and as part of a singular blast, the eruption will be rated as a low-end VEI-4. Of course, there are no signs that this is happening anytime soon, I just wanted to put into context why some caldera-forming eruption isn't soon happening. Besides, Campi Flegrei is one of the best monitored volcanoes in the world, and we are not seeing early signs of a near imminent eruption. The volcano is at a yellow alert level as it has been since 2012, and this is lower than an orange alert level that could be more worrisome. If the ongoing intrusion does continue and does not cease like its other post-1950 intrusions, then some form of volcanic eruption could theoretically happen multiple decades to a century or so from now. But once again, since all the 20th century intrusions ceased without an eruption, that will probably also be the fate of the ongoing intrusion, without a volcanic eruption occurring. Now, some additional things to debunk. Has landrise doubled during the last 9 months? Nope, it only increased by 3.5% during the most recent 9 months compared to the prior 9-month period. Are frequent earthquakes occurring? Yes, more than 99% of which are too small to be felt. Are continuous earthquakes occurring? No, there is no volcanic or harmonic tremor being detected at Campi Flegrei. Is there a dramatic year-over-year uptick in earthquakes, ground deformation, magnitude 3 or larger earthquakes, and some fumarolic vent temperatures? While all of these geophysical data categories have increased during the last decade, I would not call any of these increases as a dramatic uptick, with the closest to such being the total number of yearly earthquakes. In other words, while the number of yearly total earthquakes has increased from 250 in 2015 to 1,500 in 2020 to 7,700 in 2025, such an increase does not yet seem truly dramatic enough to suggest a volcanic eruption anytime soon, in my opinion. These elevated geophysical datasets are, after all, why Campi Flegrei is at a raised alert level. Now, if Campi Flegrei was to actually be showing pre-eruption signs before an eruption due to an ongoing strong magma intrusion, you wouldn't just expect hundreds or even thousands of monthly earthquakes, but also an exponential increase in magnitude 4 or larger earthquakes. This was the case at two volcanoes in Iceland, one in Ethiopia and one in the Philippines during parts of the 2020s. And guess what? Campi Flegrei has only produced a single magnitude 4.0 or larger earthquake in the past year, once again not supporting the internet claims of a near-imminent volcanic eruption. And finally, for everyone claiming that Campi Flegrei is a supervolcano, you are wrong. While Campi Flegrei has produced a singular mid-NVEI-7 eruption, specifically 39,850 years ago, that eruption was only 32% of the size needed to be classified as a super-eruption.